My faithful Father enduring friend, your tender mercies like a river with no end, it overwhelms me. Covers my sin each time I come into presence. I stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love still a mystery each day. Savior, you make me whole. You are the author and the healer of my soul. What can I give you, Lord? What can I say? I know there's no way to repay you, only to offer you this praise. Your grace still amazes me. Your love still each day, I fall on my knees, 'cause your grace still amazes me. It's deeper, it's stronger, it's wider, it's higher.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Martha. Thank you, Lakeisha. His grace, if it wasn't for his grace, we wouldn't be here right now. It's because of his grace we're here. Elder Assigny is going to welcome us to the table. You're going to welcome with him these words. that you'll see on the screen.
Welcome to the call to the table, and I will read my portion. After that, the congregation will follow and read your portion as well. Welcome to the table of the Lord.
The Lord.
He prepares a table before us in the presence of our enemies. He anoints our heads with oil. Our cup overflows.
Surely God's goodness and love will follow us all the days of our lives.
And we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Let one who is thirsty come, and let the one who wishes take the free gift of the water of life. We accept our King's invitation to his table and rejoice that he has accepted us and seated us together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. This time we are going to allow you to share how God has blessed you thus far. I know for myself, I am thankful that the Lord has allowed me to see another communion. He has taken me through some trials, his temptations, but because of his love for me, I've been able to overcome. I get stressed out when it comes to certain things. For example, this morning, the computer system went down here at church. I was a little bit upset because the devil was trying to mess with us. But guess what? God took care of it. Kicked him to the curb. He's not coming back in. And I praise God for that. I'm also thankful for a loving wife, one whose day has long come. Celebration, it's her birthday today, and I thank God to give her another life to share with me. Is there anyone else that want to share? Remember now, we want to be careful that we don't let your exuberance and your happiness take the time to let somebody else share. The bottom line, give somebody else a chance. Here's a mic for you right now. There's a mic right there for you. And there you go.
This time last year, I was beside myself, and the Lord has brought my husband back to well.
Amen.
And we just found out that of our 37 great-grandchildren, that we're going to have two more.
Praise the Lord.
This year, so we are praising God.
I experienced two miracles.
I don't like standing up here, but
we have one more.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I just wanted to thank you all for the prayers and all. You know, this time last year, I'd been in the hospital about a month and a half, and I had another month to go. Just the Lord brought me through. There are many times the doctors called my wife and told her I'd be on oxygen the rest of my life, and they already had me set up with a tank and that thing you carried with you to go, and I came home. I've had a rehab without oxygen. I just praise the Lord, and I thank you all for your prayers.
Amen. Go ahead.
I live on less than $1,000 a month. That's less than my rent. But I used to have my own business when I was living in Seattle. And in the process, I ended up gathering some debt. 2 weeks ago, I looked at one of my cards, and it was down to 700, and I didn't understand how it got there. It's now down to 200. The other card, there was almost $3,000 worth of debt in. I only owe $10 on it now. That's during the pandemic. That's God. Because and from my human standpoint, don't understand how it happened, but it did. And I just thank him for his love. And my daughter's alive. I don't know where she's at, but she's alive.
Anyone else? Upstairs is the balcony.
Okay, you guys think a little bit, because every one of you has a blessing, okay, if you think about it. I want to tell you, in my life, I look for opportunities to share my love with God with others, right? And it doesn't happen very often. So this week, there was two moments that came into my life that I was able to dialogue with somebody about God. And so what I want to say with this is that God is not dead. God is working in people's lives right now. And there are people out there that are searching for the Lord, and they just need to get connected. So you guys, in your relationship with God, ask God in the morning to connect you with somebody to share this good news with God. But like with Minnie and like with David, there's also other things that come into my life that God just works out situations and guides and leads, and I can see that every day, more so now than ever before. So the Lord is alive.
Amen. I just want to thank the Lord that He has mercy. And that His mercy is abundant without choice. I am a sinner, and God knows it. But God knows that His mercy overcomes my sin. I thank the Lord for this church and all the faces that I see and know. And you have touched my heart and encouraged me in times when I have been down. Praise God for you, your prayers, your honesty, your willingness, and thank God for this church. I thank you.
Amen. Amen. This is an opportunity right up here. Dawn, and hold back here first, and then Dawn.
Let's worship the Lord. Okay, I'm a Jamaican. I was in Jamaica in 2018. My son was on the track and field team. He came home and he said, "Mommy, the teacher gave me a letter to give you to sign." I said to my son, say, "Go sit down, I don't have any money." He carried home 5 times. The one to make 6, I sign it. I go to the school. The principal said to me, "Miss Kelly, since you did apply for your visa last year and you didn't get you, this year your son going for the visa, why do you don't sign up with him?" I said, "Principal, I don't have any money at that time, and at the same time, my son was going to graduate, so he came to Miami to run on the track and field." So I said, "Lord, what must I do?" Well, anyhow, I paid the money for the boat of food to go to the embassy. When I went to the embassy, the morning before I went to the embassy, I was lay on the bed crying. This song came into my thought, "Ride Out Your Storm." I don't know the song, but I'm humming the song. Anyhow, me and my son and the teacher went to the embassy. I said, "Lord, I don't want to speak to a lady. Let it be a man that I'm speaking to you, and if it's a man, make it be a form of God." Me and my son, is the fourth one, went up to the counter. The lady said to me, "Miss Kelly, did you apply last year?" I said to her, I said, "Yes." "So why I didn't get you?" I said to her, I said, "Miss, I don't know. Probably I do something wrong." Anyhow, she took my passport And she looked at it, and she put it down. She talked to my son, and asked my son some question. When he run in Jamaica, what race did he came? My son told him, he take the passport, and he put it down. I saw when she put the passport on her light, and like she stooped down and take a piece of white paper. I have gone, my first trespass is in 2018. When she hand me the white paper, the first thing I see on it, your visa is now approved. I grabbed my son, I said, thank you, Jesus. She said to me, what you said? I said, thank you, miss. She said, okay, so I'm thanking God for what he do for me. And I was a Christian back in Jamaica, but I fall from grace, and I want you all to pray for me, and I need to walk with God for eternity.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We'll continue praying for you, sister. Dawn?
You know, I came here this morning and thinking, well, this is probably going to be one of those days where we don't have many in the congregation. But you look around, and there's a lot of people here. No pastor, but we got the people here. And I'm up there at the foot washing and watching. And I love all the tears that are there because they find a peace with God, I think, that you just don't find in any news or world or anything. And I'm so grateful for this church.
We'll take one more here, up front, right here.
I'm from Eastside Church, and I just moved here from Burien, and praise God. I just want to praise God for letting me being here. I think God is working on me, and I just don't know where to go this morning, and I just Googled it, where's the nearest SDA church, and SDA Renton pop up. So God is good. I just want to shout out for Dawn for helping me to do the foot washing a while ago. That was so kind. I came here alone. So thank you, Dawn. Bless your heart. She helped me to do the foot washing, and she kneeled and prayed for me. That was so kind. Thank you for this church, for the warm welcome, and praise God, and to God be the glory.
Yes, welcome. 3 years because of that COVID thing, we were unable to do this communion foot washing. God has taken care of most of us here. We're still above 6 feet. And we're still walking around, still breathing because of his love for us. Yes.
I thank God a year by this time, we are slowly, we get some fire burn our house. By the grace of God, we all survive. Up to now, God is still lead us to hold our hands to lead us. So we thank all the church and everyone for to help us. We still need prayers. We have to move again, so we still need prayers. So everybody, we ask prayers from you. Thank you.
Praise God. Elder? Excuse me, I'm seeing you, Jack.
No, that's all right.
One more.
No, I was having some problems with my hips this week, and I had an x-ray yesterday. And I was telling the man, he was helping me. He was an older man, too, and he was helping me get up on that table. And boy, I was shooting bullets there, then, some of those hips. So, but he said, yes, we all go through those as we get older, and we have pains and everything. I said, yeah, I know. I said, I've never been old before, so I'm just discovering it. But when I pray these days, I don't have to remind God. He already knows. But I just simply telling him, from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God, and there's none else. Amen.
This was our last one.
I just wanted to thank God, first of all, that listening to testimonies is kind of refreshing. And you feel the presence of God in people's lives. Amen? Yeah, and keep inviting people to come to church. If you don't, Google will bring some over here. Thank you for coming, my sister. And I wanted to just share with you a short thought of gratitude to God, because God sometimes does things that we don't expect in life. My family prays at the beginning of the year all the time for specific things, and we are very specific. Take our child to school, to college. He did that this year. Bring us one of our family members to visit from Africa. He brought our mother. My mother-in-law is here visiting us. And even though we struggle, God still blesses us. That's the beauty about God. Don't focus on your struggles. Focus on the blessings. He will bless you while holding you in your struggles. And that's what he has done for my family. And I just want to praise him for that.
Amen. Amen. Elder Hoffman is about ready to bless those emblems that represents the Lord's body and blood for us. But before he does, I'd like to ask a question. Have you all received juice and bread? We don't want to overlook anyone if you don't have. Our deacons are ready. There's one hand over here on this side. Don, is coming. Is there anybody else? On my left, your right, near the front, Don. Raise your hand so you can see who it is that missed. Yes, okay. All right. I think that's everybody. Anybody in the balcony? Okay. I think we've got it. Okay. Elder Hoffman, I think we're ready for prayer.
Let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, here is your glory. Amen. These men and women and children, they are your reward, and we want to praise your name. Amen. The joy that is in our heart, Father, for the blood that you have spilt, for the body that was broken for us, Father, we praise your name. And we drink this and eat this in remembrance of what you have done. And we look forward to what you will do in the finish. Amen, Jesus.
Amen. The bread is what we'll take first. And if you just peel that back, so you'll know that silver portion of the juice, take a tap, hold of the tab and peel that back so we're ready to drink that juice that represents Jesus' blood, we can do so. Taken from Matthew 26. While they were eating, Jesus took bread and spoke a blessing and broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat, is my body. Let's partake." Then he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. Drink ye all of it." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out and to the Mount of Olives. Power in the blood. We'll sing together. There is power, there's power. There is power, power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Scripture reading right now.
Happy Sabbath, church. Please stand with me as I read today's scripture. Today's scripture will be from Ephesians chapter 2, verses 4 and 5. But because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in our transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. Please remain standing.
Let us sing, speak, O Lord. Speak, O Lord, as we come to you to receive the food of your holy word. Take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your love.
I'm living proof of what the mercy of God can do. If you knew me then, you'd believe me now. He turned my whole life upside down. He took the old and he made it new. That's just what the mercy of God can do. Pray with me for a moment. Lord, we came to worship you, and we came to show you reverence. You have shown us your love. You have shown us who you are, Lord, and because of the cross, you have shown us your mercy. Open our ears and open our hearts, Lord, I pray. Speak to us, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Happy Sabbath, ministry. Because this is Communion Sabbath, our message will be shortened this week, so I tried to take 50 minutes and put it into 15. A lot of it's going to be scripture, because I think what God has to say can't be said any other way than the way he said it. In Hebrews 12, 18 through 29, it describes God. It says, "For you have not come to a mountain that can be touched, and to a blazing fire, and to gloom, and darkness, and a raging windstorm, and to the blast of a trumpet and the sound of words, such that those who heard it beg that nothing more be said to them. For they could not bear the command. Even if even a wild animal touches the mountain, it will be stoned. In fact, so terrifying was the sight that Moses said, 'I am filled with fear and trembling.' But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to the myriads of angels, and to the general assembly and the assembly of the firstborn who are registered as citizens of heaven, and to God, who is judge of all, and to the spirits of righteousness, the redeemed in heaven, who have been made perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood, which speaks of mercy. A better and nobler, more gracious message than the blood of Abel. See to it that you do not refuse to listen to him who is speaking to you now. For if those did not escape when they refused to listen to him who warned them on earth, revealing God's will, how much less will we escape if we turn our backs on him who warns us from heaven? Therefore, since we receive a kingdom which cannot be shaken, let us show gratitude and offer to God pleasing service and acceptable worship with reverence and awe. For our God is indeed a consuming fire." This is who we come before. This is who you pray to. But how can God be darkness and gloom and a tempest and a blazing, even consuming fire? How can that be good news? That's terrifying. This is also who God is. You and me are not coming before a person. This is good news. The world is twisted because it wants soft and cuddly and cotton candy and pliable and a shapeable God in the clouds that will do no harm. And yet we live in a world of pushback. People screaming at majesty, at awe and wonder. I get amazed by people when they say, you know, God can't tell me what to do. Ministry, if he chooses to, I kind of think he can. The Bible refers to God as a tempest. In Job, he answered him out of a whirlwind. And I went to school at the university. I got my bachelor's degree at the University of Nebraska. This is a state where it sees 68 tornadoes a year. Now, I can't imagine standing in a field with a tornado roaring at me and a voice telling me about himself thundering out of the middle of it. What do you say? You can't look at that and say, but God, I have my own dreams and I have my own aspirations. But this is great news. A God of fire and a tempest and darkness and gloom. Well, Jack, why? Why is that good news? Because if this God is for you.
Amen.
Did you hear that?
Yep.
Amen. See, if this God is for you, who can be against you? God says, go ahead. Come on. Walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Ministry, I'm with you. But then there are people, little elder, maybe I can hit the spiritual brakes a little bit. You know, not from God, but just from the routine. You know, elder, I've been a standard bearer, and so taking a step back isn't so bad. I'll get back to it next week. I would once again, as I've been doing in 2022, challenge you. Don't negotiate with yourself. See, my deal with God is already made. It's not negotiable. Ministry, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of
wisdom.
Hebrews 5:7 is amazing to me. It says, in the days of his early life, Jesus offered up both petitions and supplications with fervent crying and tears to the one who was always able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Jesus was heard because of his reverence. The Bible says in this version of his reverent submission. Now, you would expect that he would be heard because he's the Son of God. Or simply because he is Jesus, because in Hebrew he is Yeshua. It means salvation. Salvation means preservation or deliverance from harm, ruin, destruction, loss, or sin and its consequences. So even salvation, the deliverer prayed to the one able to save him from death, as was heard because of reverence. You come before a blazing fire and a mighty tempest. The word says Moses trembled with fear before God, and he was in worship. Jesus, it's God showing deep awe and respect to God. And he was heard because of what he manifested and not because of who he was. God didn't hear Christ praying in petition to him because of who he was. Because he showed reverence. But watch this, ministry. Ephesians 2, 1 through 6 says, "And you are dead and separated from him because of your transgressions and sins, in which you once walked. You were following the ways of this world in accordance with the prince of the power of the air, Satan, the spirit who is now at work in disobedience. Among these, we all once lived in the passions of our flesh, indulging the desires of human nature and of the mind. We were, by nature, children of wrath, just like the rest of mankind. But God, being so very rich in mercy, because of his great and wonderful love with which he loved us, even when we were spiritually dead and separated from him, because of our sins, he made us alive together with Christ. And he raised us up together with him and seated us with him in the heavenly places, because we are in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable and unsurpassable riches of his grace and kindness towards us in Jesus Christ." The Most High God, El Shaddai, Elohim, Adonai, Abba, Elkanah, El Rohi, El Elohim, God Almighty, Mighty Creator, Lord, Father, Daddy, the Jealous God in Exodus 34:14, the God who sees in Genesis 16:13, God Most High is the one and only person in the universe that we have to please. So that God, a blazing fire, a mighty tempest, is also rich in mercy. He says, "We are following the course of the world. Do you know who you follow when you follow your own desires?" 1 John 5 says, "The whole world lies in the power of the evil one." But back to Ephesians 2:4, it says, "But God, rich in mercy, he died to forgive. He died for you as you." The Bible tells us by nature we are children of wrath, but God wants to pour out all his mercy on you so he can show how much grace he has. Mercy in the Greek is eleos, which is derived from the word for olive oil. Now, outside of food, olive oil was used to treat wounds. It is soothing, it is comforting, and healing. It speaks then that a merciful God is all of these things. The basic Hebrew word for mercy is rahamim. It's the plural of womb and connects mercy to womb emotion. God is not a woman, but it tells us that he carries in his heart love and emotion for us as a loving mother would for a child that she is carrying. Mercy that is soothing and comforting and healing and protective. Womb emotion. So we must move in practice of God's will. 1 John 3, 6-9 says, "No one who abides in him practices sin. No one who habitually sins has seen him or known him. Little children, do not let anyone lead you astray. The one who practices righteousness is righteous, just as he is righteous. The one that practices sin is of the devil, for the devil has sinned and violated God's law from the beginning. The Son of God appeared for this purpose, to destroy the works of the devil. No one who is born of God practices sin, because God's seed remains in him." Amen. God in you, a God of mercy. A seed of God abides in you. Today we remember his life and death and resurrection. Our Savior experienced the most vicious method of capital punishment, the cross. Ministry, trust in Yeshua, trust in salvation, trust in deliverance. It is good news that a terrifying judge a mighty tempest longs to forgive you and enter and lead you. I want to close with a short poem and a Bible verse. It says, the quality of mercy is not strained. It drops as the gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It is twice blessed. It blesses him that gives and him that takes. For he who knows secrets of all cleans the vilest wretch from sins. Even while the penitent's tears fall, mercy begins. In Lamentations 3, 22 and 23, it says, through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. I don't call men reverend because only God is to be revered. In 2023, saints, let's manifest in our hearts and in our actions reverence before God so that he hears us and he shows mercy.
Standing.
Kind, merciful Father, we have come to the end of a fiscal year. Full year 2022 is coming to an end tonight in a few hours. And so for many of us, next year is focus and what are we going to change and what are we going to do and what are we going to be, how are we going to stand Lord, you don't need more of us. We need more of you.
Amen.
Please, in 2023, be merciful. Help us, Lord, to move as you would want us to move. To share and to help as you would want us to share and help. I've prayed it before, Lord, but I pray it now because it needs to be prayed every time. Let every person that is in the sound of my voice, that is in this room, that is online, Lord, not be lost. Father, heaven, we want you, and with that comes heaven. Change us where we need to be changed. Heal us where we need to be healed. Use us where we need to be used. So that the end of 2023, we are completely transformed from where we were at the end of 2022. We love you, Lord. We ask for your mercies and your grace. Watch over us and keep us. Bring us all back here together again, I pray. In Jesus' holy name, let the church say, amen.
Please be seated.